Hello, welcome to part three of our little playthrough through Scott Pilgrim versus the World, the game, the complete edition. So we're at the park. It looks like Ramona's maxed out, so she can't learn any more moves. So I think that puts us in a pretty good position for trying to complete this. This was voted on by for this week by patrons over on Patreon, as well as Twitch subscribers right here on Twitch. Let's get things off. Let's get some Monty notes in the chat. Quark. And we'll get right to it. Not a very nice way to start that. Here. So if there's a criticism I have of this game, it's that it seems like enemies are able to combo far too easily, or just stun lock you, and there's like really no way to get out of it aside from knowing that it's coming. Have a controller's dying. Did not plan for that. There we go. Where is this key supposed to go? Place like back here where it goes? Am I supposed to just carry it throughout the entire level? Seems like it. Oh, I have no lives? Oh, that's a... that's a way to start this playthrough, or this part. Thank you. Not today, owls. At least not this time, owls. Oh, I see you. So, why are there wolverines in the park? Oh, there we go. Okay, so it did make sense. Oh, no! Jeez. Clear all, destroy all zombies. Smash them zombie brains. Whoop. Eerie Forest. Scott's evil twin. Thank you. Boom! Okay. Oh, there we go. Gideon Graves. The Chaos Theater Elevator. There we go. Whoa. Yeah. Get down there. We made it. Made it to the bottom of the elevator. Also, who puts a waterfall in the elevator? That doesn't make any sense. Oh boy. Powers, just look at him. Oh boy. A what? Stay down, Gideon. Uh-oh. Right. Yeah, the weird, like, subspace nonsense that happens at the end of the book. This does not happen in the movie. Oh boy. Pick up the sword. Well, that's just rude. I have no idea how to... Unless I cheese it by just throwing the sword. Hmm. Go, go, go! Right, how much more is there? No base. Smash those robots. Right. Works. Robots. are the worst. Oh, I can start all the way here. This is what my good buddy Josh was talking about when we were doing our co-op play. Seriously. There's no way to get out of that stun. So, game designers, please take note. Stun locks are not fun. And you shouldn't include them in your game. There should always be better option, like an option to get out of it, is what I'm saying. Also, not being able to pick up these main items. Eight items in these things. Never pick them up. when you want to, I should say. And then you always seem to pick them up when you're trying to do something else. They're always just in the way. That's not specific to this game, because you encountered that with River City Girls. So now that we know the strat for cheesing this boss coming up. And fall off. Is to just continuously throw the sword. There we go. Well, that's just silly. Sword. This is... Oh, my God. So, if this is just going to be how the last boss fight goes, and we don't finish it, in this session, I'm thinking we're just going to switch over to some other game. Can't block that, okay. So, yeah. Honestly? No. That has got to be the most poorly designed boss fight I have ever encountered. And I have encountered some really, really god-awful boss fight designs. You know, I know folks pick Scott Pilgrim, but if that's what we gotta get through in order to finish the game, basically, we're just gonna switch over and play Stardew Valley. There's a lot of personal stuff going on today that I don't want to have to deal with. That kind of BS. So, we are gonna... Let's,